हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम बैक टू अवर चैनल। अवर टुडेज पॉइंट इज सम क्वेश्चंस बेस्ड ऑन दैट पॉइंट्स व्हिच आर ऑलरेडी डिस्कस्ड इन अवर ऑल द लेक्चर्स। सो प्रॉब्लम नंबर फर्स्ट, दैट इज अ 318 माइक्रोफेरेड कैपेसिटर कनेक्टेड अक्रॉस अ 230 वोल्ट 50 हर्ट्ज सिस्टम डिटरमाइन कैपेसिटिव रिएक्टेंस। Before going to solve the questions based on that points, you must remember all the formulas which are already discussed in our lectures. So for problem number first, we have to find capacitive reactance. And we know what is capacitive reactance, what is inductive reactance. Inductive reactance means XL, capacitive reactance means XC. And formula for XC is equal to 1 upon 2 pi FC. So XC is equal to capacitive reactance is equal to 1 upon 2 pi FC. Now in the problem, what is given? That is 318 microfarad, means it is capacitor, 230 volt supply, 50 hertz, means all the quantities are given. Then it is easy to find XC. So just put all the values and find out the XE. That is 2 pi, frequency is 50 hertz, and C is 318 microfarad. So micro means 10 raised to minus 6, and the answer is 10 ohm. So answer is option number D. It's very simple. Second is Z1 is equal to 2 plus 6J and Z2 is equal to 10 plus 5J are in parallel, then find Z equivalent. Now Z1 and Z2 are the two impedance and they are connected in parallel. Z1 is 2 plus 6J, means we know mathematical representation of phasor, that is polar and rectangular form. So this form is a rectangular form, and we know that when those are connected in parallel, means two resistance are connected in parallel, so equivalent resistance is R1 into R2 divided by R1 plus R2. Similarly in AC, when two impedances are connected in parallel, so Z equivalent is Z1 into Z2 divided by Z1 plus Z2. And for multiplication, we require polar form. And for addition and subtraction, we require rectangular form. So Z1, Z2 are already in rectangular form, so we have to convert it into its polar form. So how we can represent rectangular to polar, we already discussed, but that is simple on our calculator. So just find out the polar form of 2 plus 6j and 10 plus 5j. That is Z1 is equal to, first write down in rectangular, 2 plus 6j into 10 plus 5j divided by 2 plus 6J plus 10 plus 5J. That is 2 plus 6J. We have polar form. So in polar, 2 plus 6J, 2 comma 6, 6.32 at an angle of, means again recall tan, 71.56, and 10 plus 5J, 11.18 at an angle of 26.54. Denominator 2 plus 10, 12 plus 6 plus 5, 11J. So in multiplication, we use polar form. So directly multiply the magnitudes and angle gets added, 6.32 into 11.18, that is 70.65 at an angle of 71.56 plus 26.54, that is 98.1, and 12 plus 11J, that is in rectangular, so we have polar form. So in polar, 12 comma 11, 16.27 at an angle of 42.51. Now in division we have polar form, so directly divide 70.65 divided by 16.27, that is 4.34, and in division angles get subtracted, so 91.1 minus 42.51, that is 55.59. But answer is in rectangular forms. We have rectangular form, convert polar form into rectangular. Answer is 2.45 plus J of, answer is option B. Next is question number 3. Three resistances are of 250 ohm are connected in star having 433 volt supply, then calculate the line current. In question, that is star connected. So in star applied voltage is given, that is 433 volt, 250 ohm, and we have to calculate line current. Means select any one line, that is IA, and we have to find IA. Remember, in star IA, line current is equal to phase current. Line voltage is equal to VL is equal to root 3 into VPH. So for line current, IL is equal to, that is IPH is equal to VPH divided by R. And VPH here, 433 is line voltage. So we have VPH. So VPH is equal to VL by root 3. So 433 divided by root 250 ohm. Calculate the answer, and that is 1 ohm. So answer is B. Number 4, if Z is equal to 25 at an angle of minus 45 degree, then what is R? We have to find resistance R, and this is the polar form, that is Z at an angle of phi. So we have polar form Z at an angle of phi. So that is 25 at an angle of minus 45. And rectangular form of impedance is equal to R plus JX. So we have to convert this polar form into rectangular form. Then we can easily get this R. So it's when easily find out R is equal to, R is the X component. So X component of Z means 25 into cos of angle, that is 45 degree. Answer is 17.67 unit ohm. So answer is C. If last question, I is equal to 20 sine omega t minus pi by 3, then rectangular form is. So we have to first represent this general expression in polar form and then convert it into rectangular form. So 20 sine means general expression is Im sine omega t minus phi, and that phi is pi by 3. So Im represents 20. 20 sine omega is not given, omega t, and phi is minus pi by 3. So just represent I in polar form. So polar means some magnitude having an angle. So magnitude is 20 and phi is minus pi by 3. That is 20 at an angle of minus 60 degree. So I is in polar form 20 at an angle of minus 60, and we have to find rectangular form. So in rectangular form, directly calculate in calci or theoretically, that is 20 cos of minus 60 plus J of 20 sine minus 60. The answer is 10 minus J 17.32.
ampere. So option number C is the answer.